target a different muscle group, primarily the chest. Our arms are going to be out wide. We're also going to use our biceps for this push-up. And we're going to keep the same plane alignment, neutral spine throughout the exercise. Hands are out a little bit wider than the shoulders. Flat back from my knees to my hips to my shoulders through my head. Everything is in alignment. I'm coming down. Exhale as I press up through my palms. We can also do it on our toes. Keeping our core engaged, flat back through the entire exercise. Sometimes we see a shift where people are pushed back like this. We want to keep pushing forward so that our shoulders are in alignment with our hands. Can I have a volunteer? So his hands are slightly wider than his shoulders. He comes down and up. Nice strong core. His head and his spine is neutral. Everything's in alignment. If he starts to get tired, he's going to drop to his knees. Still having a good range of motion. Keeping his body pushed forward so his shoulders are right above his palms at the bottom. Good job. Thank you.
You don't have to get down on the ground to do push-up work. We can do push-up work as an option on the wall as well. The same form also applies to a wall push-up. We want to keep our whole spine in neutral alignment. I usually start with my feet a few feet away from the wall. We're going to position our hands slightly lower than our shoulder for a wall push-up because as you come in, we want the palm to be in alignment with the shoulder. Our spine is going to be neutral from our feet. We're a straight line from our feet all the way up our leg, our hips, through our head. We're looking at the wall right here. Sometimes people want to look down at their feet. Keep your focus on the wall. Wide push-up. Hands, your elbows can go out to the sides. Exhaling as you press. As you get stronger, you can step your feet back further to use more of your body weight on the push-up. That may require adjusting your hands.